Okay, this is our fire tower trip to Loch, Erne. That's Ron and Mike. We finally found a launch after a couple setbacks this morning. We're about 6 miles further than we want to be, but it's okay. We should be okay. Our second setback of the day was the damn motor wouldn't start with the electric start, so we had to pull it. But she's running. And we got our GPS going. We got our spot going. We got our camera going, and this is Shebandawan, Middle Shebandawan. We're launching at the old towers. Used to be electrical towers over on the two islands here that went to the mine. Now we're going to see what happens. Yeah, we're running west down Shebandawan Lake. Looks like it's going to be a nice day. We're heading up here to the narrows between Middle and Upper, and then we have to head up Upper Shebandawan a few miles, then over to the portage into Loch, Erne. Hopefully we'll be able to find out exactly where the tower is. Ron used to, his dad used to work there, the tower, about 50 years ago. He was about 3 to 6 years old. He used to travel there. Getting there and checking it out. A little trip down memory lane. This is the narrows between Middle and Upper. Gonna head through here and Upper. Okay, we're just coming up on the portage across to Loch, Erne, Upper Shebandawan. We've run into some swamp here, so there's definitely no way we would have been portaging the boat through here. Fifteen years ago, this was a nice road. Used to actually be a truck at the start of this, so you could put the boat on the flat deck and drive it to the lake. Not anymore. Okay, so here we are. We're walking along Loch, Erne. Oh, I'm just talking to the camera. Trying to follow a trail here. It's getting kind of soft and spongy. Water level's up. It's gonna be an interesting trek. Once we get away from uphill a little bit and get away from the lake, we should be good. We just crossed the little creek here that comes out of Loch, Erne. It was only about 2.5 feet wide. Coming up the trail, we found an old cabin here. This definitely looks like someone lived here at one time. It's big enough.
Hey, there's news here, eh? I wonder if we could figure out what the date was. We repaired a boat here, eh?
There's no picture. You remember any of this, Ron?
Well, hey, the truth. 1984. September, December 4th, 1984.
Okay, we're down to the creek crossing, getting rid of all the little prickly things on my shirt here that are pricking me in the side. we're not getting across this area. There used to be an old bridge here, planking. We might have to head down that way to find a more solid tree. We're back at the creek again, attempting to find a spot across. And Mike seems to think that somehow we can get through here. I don't know though. It's looking pretty scary.
My goal would be to get to that log over there.
That's part of the bridge. That's part of the old bridge. You can see the notches out of it?
Yeah, exactly.
It's floated down, yeah. If anybody's going to find out how deep it is, it'll be me.
Oh, I don't know.
Wow, three. That
rolls?
Yeah. You do the log rolling?
Fuck.
Log roller, Mike, log roller. I found that log. I found the log. Whoosh!
Yeah, you're doing good, Ron. All you need to do now is to kind of come around, eh?
How the hell did you stay on this frickin' log?
Yeah, I just grabbed the grass. Yeah. I grabbed handfuls of grass. Oh, yeah, just take your time.
And now we're going to find out that there's a huge one over there. No fly.
Is there any way I can walk across here in the water?
Oh, we made it.
Yeah. This one's not that good there, Ron.
Yeah, you got the last 10 feet of a little bit of water and crap there, but
so we took a little longer detour than we expected. We followed the road and the road went past about a kilometer out of our way. So now we got to backtrack, cut across a contour around a lake and up the hill from where we saw the tower. And we got to go up. Everything's up now, and then down, and then up again. No comments? No?
No. Hoping I don't have to carry Ron out of here.
Yeah.
I think best I can.
Pretty good for a guy that had heart surgery when? April?
I was dead in April.
Dead in April, yeah. Legally dead in April. And now we're start of September. And he's climbing mountains.
So we're hiking up around a small round lake here, which is supposed to lead us to the trail going up to the tower. We're down around lake level, and it's really swampy through here. We just stepped in a little bit of swamp, but we're still heading her. We had to leave Ron about a half a kilometer ago. We ended up, we got to do a 1 kilometer bushwhack. We're about halfway there. We're fair ways up on the hill. We're hitting on the contours on an angle. We're trying to get a pinpoint on the cupola. See where this tower is. It's been tough going, but not really, really, really tough. It gets dense and then it opens up a bit and gets dense again. So it's just Mike and I left. We're gonna do this quick venture, get some photos for Ron, and then hopefully run back down the hill and meet up with him again. He'll be down waiting at the dreaded creek crossing again. That should be fun. We're getting near the top of the mountain here. Like to get a glimpse of this thing to make sure we're going the right direction. We're just heading for the highest point of the hill, hoping that some strange reason they put it up there. We're up on top of the high point, and lo and behold, move some leaves. There she be. She's orange. We've been walking for an hour through this bush trying to get our way up here. I hope it's worth it. You hear that, Ron? I hope it's worth it. Oh, not too much further now. But of course the bush gets much denser once you get closer to it. This has been a journey and a half to get here. We went a couple kilometers out of our way following roads that didn't go the right way. And even right beside the tower, I can't even see where it is. Oh, there's some steel through the bush up there. Well, we don't want to follow that GPS route back. Wow. There she is. Missing one cable. Got three cables holding her up. It's a nice calm day anyways. Okay, so we found two. There's probably two more. Old tower legs, 1955. One here, one over there. This is the outside. It might be over on that side. Take a walk, see? Just right beside the old tower. Yeah, here's another one. And nothing written on that one. So if that one, if there was a one here built in 1955, I wonder when this one went up.
I wonder why they'd build another one.
This was obviously taken off and somebody put it back up.
Yeah, yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah. Yeah, this is a little sketchy. Not even joined there. Don't let go. Okay, right on. Wow. I don't know. I had 2 liters. I drank quite a bit though. Yeah, sure. Starting to get into the breeze up here. A couple of us still looks in pretty good condition. The table's still there, the turntable's still there. That's pretty amazing. I've never seen one of these with the table still there. What a view from up here. 360 degree view. We came all the way across from that valley just over there. And there's a road that runs, kind of a road, trail that runs all the way along there. And then heads back up over to Upper Shabanawan. right, one last 360 degree view. Used to be an old wooden hatch here. You could lock it. You see where the old hinges used to be. Windows and all these. Used to be a hatch up there. And it's time to head down. These old towers are got quite a bit of history in them, but they're slowly tearing them down. It's 2013. We've already lost lots. We lost two in my area in the last 2 years. And I believe they have plans to tear them all down eventually. All these will be gone. There'll be no more history, just like the old mines. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. Okay, you got her?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. I'll get down a little lower here. Yeah, they've taken this off and somebody's put it back up, but not put any bolts in it, so. We're on the swing in here. Yeah, you'd be kind of screwed with one person. The bottom's not attached, it's just attached in the middle here, so it's like a vertical teeter-totter. Right on, thank you. Woo! Oh. And that's it, that's the tower. Okay, this is the old trail from the tower. You can barely see the tower through the trees there, right through there. This is the old trail that Ron's mom used to come down to get water from a little lake down here. We haven't seen any signs of any cabin or where a cabin might have been. Okay, we're down from the fire tower, we're all the way down the hill. We've gone to the little river here. We're trying to find our way across this river on a beaver dam so that we don't have to go a kilometer back around. That road's just over here, under 300 meters. And we're following an animal trail. We're hoping that this will take us across safely. A stove and a place and a garbage pile.
I wonder if this could have been a cabin.
This is where the cabin was. An old pot in there, tin barrels.
You take photos of all those?
Yeah. That's tin off the old cupola. It's all triangle.
Really?
Yeah. Somebody's taken it off, maybe when they took the old cupola down and then used it for shelter stuff here. Old pot. Okay, we're back at the creek crossing. We're going to try a little different approach across part of a beaver dam here.
It's pretty hard for me because I was always the guy who wasn't the wimp of the group, you know? Okay, this, coming across with Rob.
This thing, I'm gonna put in a request that you get a real pack sack next time. A real pack sack.
Yeah.
Walk right up the stream. Walk right into Lake Erne.
We made it back. Everybody's alive. A long, long day.
Speak for yourself. I'm sorry.
I'm back on Shabandoan now.
Clear,
Spiker and Radical.